lectures, we have analyzed the costs related to transport, handling, and inventories. Now we will focus on the costs related to stockouts. A stockout occurs when one or more items are not available when requested by the customers, so they cannot be delivered within the expected time window. The cost of stockouts depends on the behavior of the customers in response to the stockout. We can have real costs, such as penalties, losses related to extra discounts accorded to the customers in order not to lose the orders, extra administrative or logistics costs, for example, when the missing products are shipped later in a separate delivery. And we can have figurative costs, that is, lost profits deriving from current and future lost sales. In fact, if some products are not available, the customer can decide to cancel part of the order, that is, the missing items, the entire order, or even future orders, since he can prefer other suppliers in the future. In order to better understand how to assess stockout costs, we can consider two representative cases. First, the one of the fast-moving consumer goods, which are sold in retail stores and are ready for immediate delivery. This is a very common situation in business-to-consumer transactions. And then we will consider the case of long-lasting goods or business-to-business transactions, in which an order is issued to purchase the goods. Let's start with the fast-moving consumer goods case. When a stockout occurs, the customer can decide to buy a different product in the same store. So we have different product, same store, to buy the same product in another store, or to postpone the purchase of the product, but he or she will buy the same product in the same store when available. So same product and same store. Or finally, not to buy anything, and this is typical of goods that are nice to have, but they are not essential for the customer. For example, I don't find my favorite cookies, and I decide this is a very good occasion to start my diet plan. So I don't buy any alternative products. So no product in no store. This being the situation, how can we assess the cost related to the stockout? We have to understand, first of all, the probabilities of the different consumer behaviors. They are quite difficult to assess, and they can be estimated interacting with the customer, for example, with surveys. So we can define probability of situation number one, number two, number three, and number four. And we have to assess the loss related to each behavior. Specifically, we have to understand the amount of the loss and who sustained the stockout costs. In the first situation, there can be a loss for the manufacturer if the alternative product bought by the customer is produced by another company. This loss can be considered equal to the manufacturer unit margin of the manufacturer. In the second situation, there is a loss for the retailer equal to the retailer unit margin, since the customer buys the same product in another store. In the third situation, they are not lost sales, since the purchase is just postponed, whereas in the first situation, both the manufacturer and the retailer are losing money. So, in the third situation, nobody is losing their money, so 0 euro, and in the last one, the manufacturer and the retailer are losing their unit margin.